Today I'm here to talk about being awkward. Or maybe not being awkward. How do you get out of being awkward? Eventually, you know, with some work. Because this is awkward. And when I say this, I mean the start of a LARP is awkward. Not this photo. This photo is just here to be pretty. But why is the beginning of a LARP awkward? Everybody knows, right? So the game starts, and you're standing around a room, and it's weird. And then it's not weird, and it's fine. And what happened in the middle, right? It's not that we're not focusing. It's not that our head isn't in the game. It's that the game isn't in our head yet. What you don't have is a map. That's the thing you're missing. Now, a map is a relatively new term from the LARP discourse, unless you read last year's book. How many people here did read bits of last year's book? A bunch. Great. Cool. Well, so mapping is another tool, like all useful theory, which the point of it is to help us think more precisely about LARPs. That's the goal. It's not to try and do anything else. It's just to help us think. So what's a map? Well, a map is a mental structure for the player, not the character, for the player and an individual player. It's kind of where they keep all of their information about the LARP during runtime. So a map might contain the relationships between different characters in the game. Actions that the player thinks their character could take that are like practical and reasonable and interesting, et cetera, in the context of the game and where they are now. The character's understanding of past events at the beginning of the LARP, this part of the map is very empty because nothing has actually happened yet. Predictions about the outcome of possible actions, right? So you try and do a thing, but does it work, right? What does it actually mean? Is this thing gonna succeed in the way you think? So you make some predictions and you put those predictions in your map as you're thinking about stuff. Information about the physical space you're playing in, assuming you're playing in a physical space, or the topology of the non-physical space. You know, this is like, oh, where's the bathroom? But this is also, oh, that's the throne room where all the scary people hang out. I don't wanna go in there unless I really need to. You know, it's kind of, you know, diegetic information, structural information, et cetera. Information about the world that's relevant to the player. This may or may not have anything to do with the information that the designers thought was relevant to the player. And it also probably doesn't have very much to do with the information that the player thought was going to be relevant about the world before the game started. This is one of the things where we come to getting that map into your head. And the schedule and known predetermined events. So stuff you know is gonna happen, you know, at a certain time we will do X. There's probably other stuff, but this is, you know, that's a good summary of the kind of stuff that you need to get into your head and keep into your head. So when play starts, we have a sketch of a map, right? We have a sketch of a map from the reading that we've done before the game, from what we've learned in workshops, from what we know as far as like our tradition of LARPing. Oh yes, this is kind of how we all do LARP. This is how we do this thing. And then the game starts and we color in the map. And all of a sudden it comes to life. And that living map in our head is very, very different. It has, you know, we have all of the pressure of actual play, which tells us what is salient, what is relevant. You know, that's where we realize, oh, this entire thing about elves and the backstory, yeah, that's, anyway, moving along to what actually matters. You know, it's where that editing starts happening. But it's also about, you know, how do we actually make these facts accessible to ourselves that we might have read or that, you know, somebody yelled at us in workshop about, et cetera. And specifically, the thing that we're interested in is how we can do this faster, right? How can we color in the map faster so that we get to the point where we're not standing around awkwardly looking at each other funny in weird clothes and we're actually portraying character. I mean, unless that's your thing, Jamie. Anyway, that's how we get to the point where we're actually playing. It's fine, you can get back at me later. So here are some tips for how you can color your map in faster and get to the fun stuff more quickly. So add specific intent to the sketch of the map that you have before play starts, right? You've got some ideas in your head of kind of what you're thinking, and pick three experiences that you want from the LARP. Probably not more than that. You can pick them way before the LARP, but like in that, probably in that 15 minutes where you're probably freaking out a bit. Stop freaking out for a minute and review that list of experiences and really think, what do I want from this game? Like, what, like, really concretely, you know, if it's a super physical game, what are some things I want my body to do? What are some emotions I want to feel? Pick three, because you're going to forget more than that. And really focus on those and remember them as the game starts, not because you're necessarily going to experience them, not because you're necessarily going in that direction, but because having a focus, literally any focus, it doesn't even matter if it's right or not, is going to give you something to guide yourself and steer towards, right? And as the game starts, when you know these goals, think about what you need to color in your map first to enable you to play towards these experiences, right? Because that's the whole point, is enabling play. A living map enables you to take actions in the world. So, remember that this is awkward for everyone. It's not you, it's the process. You get to choose. You can focus on, oh my God, this is really awkward. Or you can focus on coloring in your map. And, you know, to a certain extent, if you can trick yourself to be like, no, I'm just gonna run with it. I'm just gonna, you know, accept the process. This is part of the process. Embrace the awkwardness. It will actually get less awkward. So focus on one type of information at a time. You cannot color in everywhere in your map at once, right? You don't have 17 hands. If you do have 17 hands, you're going to have a very interesting time making costumes. But for the rest of us, if you try to do everything at once, you're going to end up feeling paralyzed and overwhelmed. And that's part of that awkwardness is, oh God, I have 75 characters to remember, and I know like two. That's fine. How many relations do you have? Okay, go and talk to those relations. One by one, 2 minutes. Like the shortest conversation. See the player in the living game, in whatever they're actually wearing that wasn't what they were wearing in the workshop. Hopefully you can actually find all of them. That's a separate problem. But, you know, but like try and just have the briefest of interactions. And they don't have to mean anything. But that means that the next time that you come to that person, you've got something to lean on, right? Because you've already talked to them once. And now you've got some living history in the actual real map of the LARP that actually happened to go back to. Walk through the space as your character. You know, as we said, you know, fine, the workshops, whatever, it's a space. Oh, now that's the scary place where we don't go, right? This matters a lot for your character to know this. The sooner you can figure it out, the better. So try to visit all the spaces that it makes sense for your character. And if you realize that your character can't visit some of them, well, great. Now you know some things about that space. But again, you're building muscle memory inside the character and inside the game. And then again, another three. Think of three actions that you can do in the first hour, right? You want to steer towards something, right? You know, you've got experiences that you want to steer towards, or what's an action that's going to teach you about your character, right? You know, you've just started playing this character. You don't really know who they're going to be yet. So find an action that's going to teach you something about your character, or find an action that's going to teach you something about your relationship, with some other character. Because, again, the relationship that we thought we were going to have, well, now it's the actual game. Does that relationship matter? Does it not matter? Is it, you know, what does it actually feel like when we're playing for real? Go find out. You know, and smallest possible things. These don't have to be big, but they have to be immediately accessible. And the quicker you can do them, the faster you get the feedback loop and the faster you can color in the map. Finally, use a characterization shortcut. You are, like, portraying a character, especially at the start of the LARP, takes a huge amount of concentration and focus because you don't have any of the rhythms and patterns set in for this. Johanna had a great piece in this in last year's book on basically pick something that's completely overblown, right? Whether it's the crazy accent or whatever it is, right? You pick some really obvious, overly acted thing and just lean into it. Because if you're leaning into that, then you don't have to think as much about what the rest of your character is doing. And it makes your character easier to read and thus map for everyone else who is also dealing with this problem. You will have time for nuance later, so just lean in and run with it and figure it out later. If you're more interested in more on mapping, see Maps, Loops, and LARPs in last year's book, which you can also buy at the info desk tomorrow if you don't have a copy. Thank you.